The manual logger web services is an optional feature that allows communication between the manual logger mobile device and a web server. In order to use this feature, I must have a web server configured for communication with the manual logger mobile device. If the web server has wireless capabilities and my PDA has wireless capabilities, then I will be able to send data back and forth through a wireless access point. That means that I'll be able to send data from my PDA to the server from the field. The setup of the optional web services is simple. I'd like to show you how this is done. You will need the assistance of your network administrator. I have a Windows server here, running Windows Server 2003. This server is configured as a web server. It is also running Internet Information Services 5. In order to configure the web service, we need to go to Administrative Tools, Internet Information Services. In here, I want to create a new folder that will contain the information and the files that my server will need to communicate with manual logger mobile device. Once I open IIS, I will be able to see my server, which in this case is OSIsoft-DC. If I expand my server, I will see a folder called Websites. If I expand that, I will see the default website. Under the default website, I want to create a new virtual directory. If I right-click on the default website, I can go to New, Virtual Directory, and in here follow the steps of the virtual directory creation wizard. The alias for my new virtual directory is going to be PIMLWebServices. Click Next, and now I will have to browse to the location of that folder, which is under C, Program Files, PyPC, PyML Web Services. This is a folder that was created during the installation of Manual Logger when I selected the optional Web Services feature. I click OK, Next, and I can set the permissions for my folder. Please be conscious of security concerns when setting the permissions, and always check with your network administrator. In my case, I'm going to allow full control to my folder. I click Next and Finish. I can see that the PIML Web Services folder has been created under the default website. In order to complete the process, I need to run a configuration tool for web services. If I open Windows Explorer, this tool is going to be located in the same PIML Web Services folder under C, Program Files, PyPC, PIML Web Services. The name of the tool is PIMLTools.exe. If I open that tool, I want to go to the database tab and click on Setup Connection. In here, I want to enter the name of the appropriate server, which in my case is OSIsoft-DC, and the correct name of the database, PIML Windows. I test the connection, which was successful, so I can apply the settings. In order to ensure that the web server has been configured appropriately, I can conduct one last test. I can open Internet Explorer and go to the website that I created, which is OSIsoft-DC, PIML Web Services and open the PIMLWebServices.asmx file. If I can see this window, that means that the web server has been configured appropriately and I can now test the connection. If I click on test the connection and invoke that process, I should be able to obtain a window similar to this one, where I can obtain the database information, its version number, the name of the SQL server, and the name of the PI server. Now I know that my web server has been appropriately configured to communicate with the PDA.